Ladies and gentlemen, this is the WBO European Super Middleweight Championship. Please welcome into the ring the challenger from Romford, Lee Markham!
Well, it's a step up in class for Lee Markham. How well is he going to handle the atmosphere fighting in a big arena like this Wembley Arena? Only lost twice. And he does have that amateur win against Buglioni. But the game from that situation just might have moved on a bit.
Yeah, you know, it's been a needle in this fight as well. I've been watching a couple of things and saw some media come back between the two. Both of them can punch. I think both of them are going to go straight at it from the first bell.
Well, Lee said he's always going to be wide open to right hands, whatever he does, and that's my best punch.
Yeah, you know, obviously, Essie's going to go looking for straight away, and, you know, Buglioni has shown in the past that he is over the hand right. And you say, lad, the opposition, I think his last fight was a close fight against Jermaine Smile. He gives anyone trouble.
Yeah, Jermaine Smile is here somewhere, I gather, and he'll be keeping a very close watch on this because he'd like to fight the winner.
Please welcome into the ring the WBO European Super Middleweight Champion from Enfield. He's the wise guy, Frank Buglioni!
His fans here in numbers as ever. And he looks happy, he looks confident. Working with the Collins brothers nowadays. He says that Pascal Collins has improved in 50%.
I think with Buglioni, the one thing you have to do is tighten him up. Yeah, get a bit more head movement in him. Just tighten him hands up a bit.
Well, he says that Tom Baker and Luke Blackledge turned him down for this fight. He did say that Jermaine Smile had turned him down as well. I'm told emphatically by them, not so, they'll have it. Smile, who beat Lee Markham narrowly on points at your call. Frank Buglioni, though, here. Well, he regained the title in an entertaining scrap against Andrew Robinson, and then an eye-catching quick stoppage win since then. What's he going to bring tonight?
Ladies and gentlemen, Frank Warren for Queensbury Promotions, sponsored by Raynham Steel, proudly presents 10 three-minute rounds for the WBO European Super Middleweight Championship, live from the SSE Arena Wembley here in London. Your officials are appointed by the World Boxing Organization, and your three scoring judges at ringside are Ferenc Budaj of Hungary, Jose Ignacio Martinez of Spain, and Mr. Dave Perez of the UK. Your WBO supervisor in charge is Istvan Kovács of Hungary. Your British Boxing Board of Control steward in charge is Mr. Mick Collier. Your timekeeper at the bell is Bob Edgeworth. And when the action begins, your referee in charge is Steve Gray of the United Kingdom. And now to introduce the contestants. Firstly, fighting out of the red corner, stands a man whose record reads 14 wins, 2 losses, with 7 KOs to his name. At yesterday's weigh-in, he scaled 11 stone, 13 pounds, 5 ounces. Please welcome, from Romford, Lee Markham! And across the ring, in the blue corner, stands the WBO European Super Middleweight Champion. A man whose record reads 16 wins, 1 loss, with 12 KOs to his name. At yesterday's weigh-in, He scaled 12 stone, and tonight he wears the white and gold shorts. Please welcome, from Enfield, the wise guy, Frank Puglione! Your referee will now give his final instructions to both boxers.
Okay, boys, if a call breaks, you've got to take one step back. Don't any of your punches go on the back of the head, and most importantly, protect yourselves at all times. Touch them up. We don't go too deep. Come on. Good luck, boys.
Ladies and gentlemen, 10 three-minute rounds for the WBO European Super Middleweight Championship.
Well, you know what could be coming. Frank Puglione, we all know, he can bang. But, as Sergei Kamitsky showed us, it can be a bit of a flawed sort of exhibition that he brings in. And Lee Markham says his best shot is the right hand. What's going to happen? 12 rounds. 10 rounds, I beg your pardon. WBO European Super Middleweight title at stake.
This is job there with Markham. A right hand landed straight away. And a left hook.
Well, he started as though he's really charged up, isn't he?
Yeah, yeah. You've seen from the introductions, he's ready to explode. And he comes straight up on Leone, throwing that jab. Landed a nice little right hand, left uppercut. I'd like to see Puglione just put a little bit more snap in that jab.
A nice right hand from Puglione. Pawing a bit with that left hand lead.
Yeah, he needs to, you know, gain Markham's attention with that jab, snap the jab in his face.
Well, he's going looking, isn't he, with that swinging right hand, Markham. Nice body shot, and again from Puglione.
That was a lovely shot.
As suggested on his way into the ring. Is he going to be fazed by the atmosphere, Markham? Well, he's certainly gone out with aggressive intent in the opening stage of this opening round.
Yeah, he doesn't look like, but he landed some nice couple of shots at the start of the round, but Puglione's come back, picked his shots lovely, especially that left hook to the body.
That's the one, that's what he needs.
That's the one that Markham's going to be looking for, that right down on the side.
See, physically, Puglione, a much bigger man, stands 6'1", and he's trying to impose himself now.
Yeah, he looks a much bigger man on the night as well. You know, Puglione just flicking that jab out, looking for a shot, looking to open Markham up. I'd like to see him snap that jab in a little bit more. Give Markham something a bit more to think about.
Again, caught by the right hand, followed by the uppercut. Markham's getting enough success in this opening round to suggest that he can maybe find something special.
Yeah, it looks like he's going to warm up and do a nice fight, this one. Nice uppercut back by Puglione, another nice uppercut.
Well, I didn't see them when they fought as amateurs, but I wouldn't mind betting that there's been more action in this opening round than there was in the whole of two amateur contests.
You know, none of them seem to want to be given an inch at the moment. You know, both trying to push each other on the back foot. Some good punches landed by both fighters.
Both of them trying to really load up. Interesting one for three judges to look at this opening 3 minutes.
Yeah, it's pretty hard to score this one, John. You know, they've both had their moments.
Good round, that, Enzo.
Yeah, it's cracking. None of them wanted to give an inch. Markham set the stall up nice and fast. Puglione come back with them lovely body shots. Very, very good close round. I should be that is that right hand. I think that was straight away. Puglione come back with the jab.
Well, everybody knows, don't they, that Puglione can be caught by those shots, and that's what Sergei Kamitsky showed us, and he's a fighter who's a similar sort of stature to Markham, and I'm sure he'll have studied that long and hard.
Yeah, you know, he's sometimes that Puglione just pouring that jab or holding the jab out, which gives Markham a chance to throw that right hand over the top.
Keep moving to your right, okay, away from his left hand, and you're moving it slowly, cracking that right hand over the top. He's throwing that slow jab, Frank. It's So I want you to time that right hand off. Okay?
Yeah.
Just let it go. Snap it. Snap. As the round goes on, it lands even better. Okay.
Yeah.
Great round.
Defense.
Great round.
Well,
well, I'm saying great round. I made it a close round. How did you score it, Enzo?
To be honest, I think I just edged it towards Markham.
Not a lot in it.
No, not
tight
a lot.
Sort of round.
You know, it was, I think it was just the more eye-catching shots coming from Markham. You know, Bullioni got back into the fight.
And the chants which you hear in the background, I think, are from the Markham fans, principally.
Yeah. It's strange for Bullioni's fans to be out shouted. He normally takes the brunt of the fans at one of the shows.
Jab from Markham, doubling up.
Yeah, but Bullioni caught him straight back with a stiff jab of his own. You know, I just like to see Bullioni gain his attention by throwing that big jab. That's better.
They said as one.
And throw the jab, throw the feint, then throw a jab. He's moving to his left all the time, Bullioni. He needs to move away from Markham's right hand.
Well, they were telling him that's in the corner between rounds, to be fair. Maybe the point needs to be made a bit more emphatically. A couple of right hands, if Markham gets any more success, might be a reminder.
Yeah, he's just walking straight.
That's a good shot.
Lovely shot. When he puts his punches together well, he looks really good.
Bullioni does have the power. There's 12 stoppages and he's 16 wins.
Yeah, he does. He definitely can bang, but you know, Markham's record suggests he can bang a little bit himself.
And he's keeping coming.
Nice body shot, tap the head, left hook underneath.
Good head shots.
Lovely shots back by Bullioni.
Stepped away and gave himself room for that right uppercut beautifully,
yeah,
Bullioni.
Yeah, it was lovely. Just give himself a little bit of room. Throw them shots. You know, Markham's trying to crowd him at the moment to stop his shots, but Bullioni's picking some lovely shots inside.
Markham, the man who likes to be on the front foot, though.
Yeah, he does, and you can see that, but he's put an awful lot of work in just trying to take the fight to Bullioni.
Good movement, nice. That.
Yeah, just throw the shot, step away.
And stepped away to the right, which is what you've been looking for.
Yeah, step away. See, you know, Markham's looking for that right down. He's shown from the first round. Balloon just needs to keep moving to his left and stay at the distance.
See, nice tight guard, though, from Markham there as Bullioni tries to tee off.
Yeah, I think he's just tapping the shots away, just a nice little uppercut by Markham. And he's just trying to tap the shots to see where Markham's throwing his shots.
Another good round. Styles make fights, and this is good to watch.
Yeah, you know, we thought this was going to gel, and it certainly has.
Well, that's good work in
reverse gear
from Bullioni and landing a quality shot right on the bell. Tight round, but I thought a bit better for Bullioni.
Yeah, definitely a Bullioni round. You know, he outworked Markham. He landed a better shot. Yeah. You know, Markham did have his success. But ultimately a Bullioni round.
Slowly, keep your hands up nice and high. Okay, if he throws a combination at you, you've got to answer him. We're another combination. Just let the shots go.
Yeah.
Okay, two and three shots. Even if they're not getting through the guard, just let them go anyway, okay? We always finish that body shot. Always finish that hook to the body. Because he's pretty tight defence. You're throwing bomb, bomb. Watch the elbows open.
Shots at that
look at that shot.
Lovely
shot.
Double lift up to the body. Beautiful. Come on. Don't end up on silly. He's still dangerous, mate. Still dangerous.
Yeah, you've got to soften him up with him body shots.
Yeah.
Lenny Butcher with Lee Markham. Silverhaired corner man who was long-time trainer of Dominic Negus, who's the owner of the gym, the Sparta gym, where Markham works out. Frank Bullioni with Pascal Collins, younger brother of Steve, who's also in that corner tonight. He's a hard man, Steve Collins.
He still looks like he can have a fight as well, John.
Certainly wouldn't venture the suggestion otherwise. I think Chris Eubank could still like another go at him.
I'd put him, especially outside of a ring, I'd put him only on Steve. big fan of Steve Collins.
Me too.
You know, wore his heart in his sleeve every time he boxed.
Likeable bloke, and the first time I've And I've said it before, first time I met Freddie Roach when he was with him.
Good head movement there by Buglioni. You know, he's making Markham miss a little bit. He's just capitalising them missed shots from Markham. So just keep popping the jab. Markham needs to get in close, put the pressure on Buglioni, just make things uncomfortable.
He's not ploughing forward with quite the enthusiasm that he did in the opening round. Not Markham, enough. And he's starting to take a few.
Yeah, and it's a lovely Buglioni, throw some lovely shots, pick some lovely shots.
Not been able to find the right hand, which is the bingo punch. Not been able to really land that with any sort of authority so far in this round, Markham. No, looking for it.
Yeah, and that's the problem, John. He's looking for it. He's not setting it up. He's you know, Buglioni knows he's throwing that right hand. Just moving his left away from Markham's right hand and just catching him in nice little shots coming in.
And seeing it coming, keeping that left hand tight to his head when Markham comes forward, did get through with that right hand, but it was kind of telegraphed and didn't really do any damage.
Yeah, he's boxing well this one, Buglioni. Good movement, good change of levels of the punches. Good variety of punches as well. Right up the body, jabs, right hands. Good uppercut there by Markham. You know, he's still in the fight. Good left hand by Markham. Good All jab right. back by Buglioni.
Gets the Markham contingent roaring their support.
Nice right uppercut as well.
Buglioni almost ducked into a right hand there.
Yeah, he just got away with that one. You know, this is where Markham has his most of his success, coming forward, hands up nice and tight.
It's more like it for the jab from Buglioni. I know that's what you've been calling for, stiffer jab.
Yeah, just
from
like
the home fighter, the Enfield man.
Yeah, I just like to see him throw a stiff jab, just stop Markham in his tracks. I think what Buglioni's doing is just pouring that jab out, touching that jab, looking for another big shot. Just snap the jab in his face, stop him coming in.
That's a good shot from Markham. And he's keeping ploughing forward. The big shots from both guys, but Buglioni had the bulk of that round, even though Markham finished strongly.
I think Markham had a good last 30 seconds of the round, although Buglioni boxed well for the first part, three quarters of the round, so we've got to give that round to Buglioni. But Buglioni needs to just pop that jab, put a bit more power on it, put more emphasis on the power, and just stop Markham in his tracks. Just stop him coming in, stop him loading for that right hand. Markham, on the other hand, needs to get in close and rough Buglioni up. That's when he's having his success.
Keep your warfare up a little bit, okay? Keep it up a little bit, because you can't do that. I don't want you to get into a slugfest, but I want you driving them shot, cracking them. I also want you driving them shot, cracking that right hand under the body too. Keep that long range with him. When he gets in close, don't just stand there with him. Automatics. Ha, ha. Even if you don't land, it looks good to the judges, okay? A fight, a great fight.
Yeah, defense
okay.
is great. Fight.
Three rounds down. Okay, he's picking up a little bit. Now you push him back.
Three rounds gone. Enzo's got it 2-1 for Frank Buglioni as we go into the fourth.
Great advice there by Pascal Collins as well. Pretty much what we've been saying. Just put a little bit more power into your shots. Just stop him in his tracks.
10-rounder for the WBO European Super Middleweight title. Buglioni defending his belt.
That's better from Buglioni, just everything off that jab. Dictating where the fight's taking place now, he's pushing Markham on the back foot.
Ramming the shots through, don't get involved in a slugfest. Oh, he's caught there, though.
Nice left hook there by Markham, but, you know, he got caught, but no reaction there by Buglioni. But he just needs to keep that jab in his face, keep that jab, keep that distance. Don't allow Markham to get close. And like I said, Markham, on the other hand, he needs to get close. He needs to try and work his way in and bully Buglioni.
Markham starting to mark up a little bit. Left eye looking a little bit reddened.
Yeah, he's eaten a lot of shots as he's coming in. And Buglioni, that jab's constantly in his face.
Being out-punched now, Markham, which wasn't the case in the early stages.
No, he is.
Volume of punching I'm talking about.
Yeah, and nice shots as well, especially finishing up with that body shot.
That's a quality left hook from Markham, but the single shot.
Well, Markham's been landing some good shots, but like you said, John, the single shots, every now and again, Buglioni's doing the brunt of the work and good shots. It's nice to see from Buglioni tonight is he's not as reckless as he normally is. although I like watching the recklessness, I'll be honest, John.
Well, it's a kind of what makes him a you can't take your eyes off him kind of fighter, because exciting though he is and heavy-handed though he is, we know he can be caught, and that's what like that, and you can't take your eyes off it for a second, because you never know.
Yeah, he wears his heart in his sleeve, and you know, that's enjoyable to watch.
But now, can Markham come on strong in the last minute?
Which he's been doing the last couple of rounds, but ultimately Buglioni's doing too much work in the first three quarters of the round.
He's walked him down and got him into the toe-to-toe exchange, and Buglioni getting the better of it. Terrific stuff.
Yeah, lovely combination of punches there by Buglioni.
Then back came Markham with a solid left hand of his own.
I think the Buglioni of a couple of fights ago, he just stood there and traded. Wouldn't have thought about defence. Now he's thinking about his defence, which is, you know, going to take rats off to Pascal and Steve Collins.
Markham's got himself into great shape for this fight, though. He knows that the way to beat Buglioni is doing what he's doing here, right on his face and launching some big shots. Needs to find the right hand. It's good from Buglioni, fighting well off the ropes, but there is that right hand. And another, and another.
Again, another last good last 30 seconds of the round for Markham, landing some heavy shots, but Buglioni's round.
Okay, thank you.
Well, that was breathtaking stuff in the last 30 seconds. Oh, big left hook that was from Markham.
Took it well, in fairness to Buglioni. Clean shot as well. Well, Markham's just trying to get close. He's eating a lot of punches getting close, but when he gets in close, he knows that's when he got a chance. He knows he can drag Buglioni into that.
When he gets inside, automatics. Don't just let him punch. Just automatics. Break him up inside, okay? Let's start fighting a long range again.
Okay.
All right, push him back. Let him come. Double jab, right hand. Double jab, right hand. Left hook. You cut him a good left hook at long range. When he gets inside, his hands are too tight. That's his game, okay? Keep it on long range.
You see that damage around the left eye I was talking about during the action in that fourth round. Fifth round of the 10 rounder. Buglioni, we've got 3-1 up.
Yeah, good fight as well, John. Well, 3-1 up, but very competitive each round.
Now the Buglioni fans get into voice.
I like the fact that Buglioni's listening to the corner nowadays. You know, he's been told to keep it at a distance, and that's what he's doing.
Markham's got to keep a tight guard as he tries to walk him down and get into range. He just didn't want to be a goalkeeper soaking up big right hands to make that left eye worsen.
Yeah, you know, he's a static target walking in. He's walking straight ahead. Just move his head a little bit more. Double that jab to get in. Give Buglioni something to think about. But at the moment, Buglioni's just catching him in lovely little shots as he's coming in.
Yeah, and boxing nicely, Buglioni, in the opening minutes of this round. This has kind of become the pattern in the last two or three rounds. Steve Gray rightly getting onto Buglioni's case about using the forearm to push his man away. There's a solid left hand from Markham. Maybe this will signify a stronger period now from the challenger.
You know, that's where Markham needs to be, in close. No, he can't. I don't think he can compete with Buglioni at the boxing stakes. But you know, he's strong, he's fit, and he needs to get in close to Buglioni.
Buglioni pushed him away with the forearm again, and once again the referee Steve Gray spoke to him about it. Didn't want to incur the wrath of the referee to the extent where there's a danger of him getting a point taken away. That's good from Buglioni, using the ropes well.
And he's moving to his right as well, moving away from Markham's left hand, right hand. No, as I say that, he moves on to the right.
Yeah, he's boxed beautifully, though, in the first couple of minutes or so of this round.
Yeah,
but this is where Markham starts to come on strong in the last two or three.
Yeah, this has been the pattern of the last couple of rounds. You know, Buglioni dictates the first 2 minutes of the fight. Markham comes back stronger. He's just leaving it just a little bit too late.
Oh, good uppercut.
Lovely uppercut. Tap the body, bang with the uppercut.
Big attack. That's a solid left hook as well. Buglioni feels the weight of that. Markham has to keep those fists going, has to keep pushing the arms. Instead, it's Buglioni who puts a flurry of punches together and has to take a good left hook.
You know, this is where Markham wants to be. You know, he needs to keep Buglioni there. Buglioni, on the other hand, needs to get a distance, get a range. There's that right hand, that's the one Markham's looking for.
Puglioni, volume of punches, though, surely is taking him this round, even though Markham is on the front foot once again in the closing stages. Yeah, that's really good from Puglioni.
Yeah, Markham's landing the more eye-catching shots, but, you know, every time he lands a one or two, Puglioni fires back with two or three. He's got to be very careful using that shoulder now, using that elbow. He's been warned once about it.
Puglioni around, Enzo.
Yeah, good.
Enzo? Enzo.
Enzo. You haven't boxed before, John, have you?
You're the one who's supposed to have taken shots.
I know. We're all over the place. I'm always pointing you out.
Okay.
This is championship rounds. You've got to win.
Slow it down a little bit, okay? Don't be dancing around wasting energy. But keep at him at the end of your push. When he gets close, he's going, pam,
I bet it's just
pam.
Nice to actually look someone in the eye when you're talking to him, John, rather than Barry looking down on him.
It's really bright. Bright and with it, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's boxing well. He's boxing really well. You know, he's allowing Markham just that last 30 seconds, last 40 seconds of the round. But he's answering back every time Markham comes back with two or three shots. Puglioni comes back with two or three in his own.
Banjo, Lee Markham getting in close. That was a good uppercut.
Yeah, he's landing some eye-catching shots. But, you know, he's being outworked for the majority of the round.
Second half of the fight. Puglioni well clear on points. At least that's the way we're seeing it.
Yeah, you know, a couple of these have been close rounds, but, you know, I think Puglioni's dictated three quarters of the round and Markham's coming strong towards the end. But Puglioni's, even when Markham's coming on strong, Puglioni's having an answer.
Markham now, landed a couple of good jabs of his own. Puglioni keeps it at this range, and there's really only one winner.
Yeah, that's what he needs to be. You know, he's landing some good shots. He lands some great hands. Every time he's up close, Markham's got a chance. Because Puglioni likes to fire back, and when he fires back, he's giving Markham that opportunity. But when Puglioni's boxing, I don't think Markham's got an answer to him.
He's getting away with quite a lot of pushing, Puglioni. I could think of a few referees who might take a dimmer view of it.
Yeah, he's got to be careful, but... You know, he's finding it hard to keep Markham off.
Markham just walking him down. He's coming in pretty much in straight lines, just in with a tight guard, trying to just walk into range and then land big shots. Now here he is. Is this his moment?
You know, much, much better start of the round so far than he's had in the previous rounds.
Well, if his corner are doing the right job, they must be telling him that he's behind and he's got to start putting punches together. And volume of punches.
Those are the sort of shots he needs. Two to the body, two to the head.
6th round it was that Puglioni began to unravel against Kamitsky. It was where the fight ended. Although, in fairness, Kamitsky had been well on top before that, which Markham certainly isn't.
Yeah, because Kamitsky got a lot of experience, whereas Markham hasn't. And, you know, he's walking forward, he's taking a lot of shots coming in, which is allowing Puglioni to pick the points up. But although Markham has had a much better round this round.
He's making Puglioni fight his sort of fight.
Yeah, this is the best round for Markham for a long time. He had more success, he backed Puglioni up, he stayed close to Puglioni, which is what he needs to be. Some lovely body shots going in as well. Nice uppercuts, right hands.
Puglioni really struggling at this stage to keep him off.
Yeah, he looks tired now, Puglioni, but he's still throwing some lovely shots. And Markham knows that he needs to be at this distance. This is his distance, this is his range where he's happy.
Becoming a hard man's fight, this, Enzo.
Yeah, it's a tough fight, you know, they're standing together, they're throwing big shots, two of them.
People bellowing their encouragement from ringside and up in the bleachers. What a good round.
Good round. I think I'll have to give that round to Markham. It's the best round he's had for a long time. You know, the full round. He kept on Puglioni from the start. He made things hard for Puglioni. Puglioni just didn't get that distance, didn't get that range where he was able to work.
You know what he's doing, you're getting a better of him, you're pushing him back, he's getting tired, but he just puts that big flurry in, you know, he ain't doing nothing.
He's hitting gloves all the time, but sometimes he's looking at he's doing stuff, so you've got to come give yourself that space, yeah? Give yourself that space and fire off some good shots. You need that roll under, he's there for it, all right? just
right, roll that body shot.
Breathe up there. Can I cut a big breath here? Do me a favour, then. Just get him to stand up early, just to fucking sight him, right? Just get up a little bit early. Get up and show him now that you're ready to go, all right? He's smart. He's built.
On this point, and you know it. Okay, Frank, you've got to throw more punches, okay? Your defence is good.
Psychological there. We haven't even fucking taken punches, Frank, okay?
Pascal Collins sounding a little bit more anxious than he was earlier on.
Yeah, very animated in that corner.
Enzo's got Buglioni 4-2 in front as we go into the seventh. Last round was a tight one. It's what you're impressed by. There were the flurries of punches from Buglioni, but when he got into range, Markham seemed to have more on his shots in that last round.
Yeah, I think Markham in the last previous rounds, he'd been getting close towards the end of the round. The last round, he got close straight away and he made Buglioni work for the entire round. And, you know, he backed Buglioni up, he caught him some lovely shots. Again, you know, he's trying to push Buglioni on the back foot. It doesn't seem a lot of snapping Buglioni's shots at the moment.
Well, he's getting tired. I thought he was a little bit gassed in the closing stages of that last round, and he looked mighty tired when he was on his stool in the corner receiving the Collins invective.
Yeah, he's about to throw a lot of punches to keep Markham off him.
Uppercut inside there from Markham, pushing Buglioni back. And Buglioni is just pushing his punches a little now. There's not the snap that there was.
Yeah, it's not no snap in his shots. He's allowing Markham to get close. No, he needs to be whipping these shots in to keep Markham away from him.
Huge opportunity this for Lee Markham. Biggest fight of his career by a long way. Good right hand.
Good right uppercut, left out of the body as well. Buglioni is just finding it very hard at the moment to keep Markham off him.
Well, I'm sure in an ideal world he'd love to jab and move Frank Buglioni, but when you've got a guy like this who just keeps on coming like some
good
sort
shot.
Of crazed animal in there, it is very difficult to stick to a game plan. Markham is making it his sort of fight.
Well, Buglioni's fighting back, it just didn't seem to snap there.
Oh, he's caught again by a left hook.
Well, that's better than Buglioni, just move that head, just dip the legs, roll the legs, roll the shoulders.
Now Buglioni gets on his toes and does find a little bit of lateral movement.
Really good fight this, John. Really enjoying.
There's the right hand from Markham.
Yeah, it's been a right and left, and it's a good uppercut there by Buglioni.
Both of them connected with uppercuts. Another terrific round.
You said this is a tough man's fight. I think this might boil down who wants him more.
It's not pretty, is it? It's not science.
No, but
by God, there's guts aplenty. People are standing up and applauding.
Okay, you gotta keep pushing back, you gotta keep working. That's all you gotta do.
Okay.
But I tell you what, don't shop in your hands when you're doing it. If you're trying to do some good work in there, you're letting your shots go, and you're dropping your hands and staying waiting. When you throw them shots, get close to them, smudge them. Throw your shot, pop, pop, pop. Get close to them, smudge them. Don't let him get off the shots.
Yeah.
Referee has to come in and break it, let him break it. Okay. But yes, you're doing great work, then leaving your chin hanging, okay?
Yeah.
Don't
Frank,
do that,
Frank. Three rounds to go, Frank. Break your heart, okay? Do that.
He was showing. Roll around your throat and run on for that left hook. Every time he's catching you.
His hands are there every time.
Right. Do the double. Bang, bang. Yeah? Up. In here, up there. Come on. You've got to work, you've got to keep working it.
It's going to push it. It's getting a bit desperate now, because he knows, right? Put a little bit of pressure on, right?
He does, you push him over, and then he just throws a little...
Trying to rev Lee Markham up. But is the fight beginning to slip away? We've got it 5-2 as we go into the eighth.
Yeah, they just told Markham, no pressure from the start. They realise that's his best chance to get the win, to put in pressure on Buglioni, pushing Buglioni back. Good job there by Markham.
Well, some people at ringside have got it a little bit closer than we have. We've got it to Buglioni. The rounds have been tight, though. It's been that sort of fight,
yeah,
hasn't it?
It was a couple, I think, the one round I weren't 100% on was the last round. No, I could quite have easily give that round to Markham.
Markham's been the guy on the front foot and the one who's looking as though he's applying pressure, even though the volume of punches has been with Buglioni, and he has, as we've said before, he's just started to, boy, he didn't want to take shots like that. Good left hook.
I think we've got it 5-2, John. I think it could quite easily be 5-3. 4-3, sorry. You know, they've been some good rounds. But it was good advice in the corner from Markham. Get close, put the pressure on. You know, he's allowing Buglioni to work now.
And they did tell him that he couldn't miss with his left hook. And hey presto, the left hook to the chin. The best punch he's thrown in the round. And again, Buglioni looking to be throwing volume of punches there, but there's not really anything on those.
No, but he's just giving the impression he's working. He's outworking Markham. But the corner did tell Markham before he throws the left hook, roll the shoulder.
Oh, he walked into a right hand there. And now here comes Markham. Sees an opportunity. Did Buglioni's leg stiffen, but now Buglioni comes back and shows great fighting heart.
Buglioni. No, it's one thing Buglioni got, he's got plenty of heart.
Terrific exchange. And that huge effort again from Markham. Into the final minute of this eighth round. Hellishly difficult to score these in exchanges like that.
Yeah, it was pretty even round, but the more I catch the shots this round come from Markham. But again, wouldn't surprise me if people have seen it the other way. Good shots there for Buglioni. Markham's just relentless, just keeps coming forward.
He is fighting with a rare passion. Good left hand again from Markham.
Well, he wants this fight, he wants this belt.
It's a life changer for him if he can win this.
Yeah, of course it is. You know, he's
good shot.
Good left hand, good right hand, good left hand.
And Buglioni takes it well. Great right hand in the last 10 seconds there from Markham. Buglioni gets through though. Torrid times. A great round again.
Yeah, brilliant round. I've scored that one to Markham. You know, he done well. He had a good first half of the fight. He had a good last half of the fight.
He
caught Buglioni some lovely shots, and fair play to Buglioni. Took a good shot. Took a good couple of shots then.
Well, if that goes to Markham on your card, that is 5-3 Buglioni. And look at Markham fighting like a man possessed.
Yeah, every punch in the back end, one, twos, left hooks, right uppercuts. Really good box, really good, I wouldn't say box, really good fighting by Markham.
It's fighting, isn't it? I mean, yeah. This is nothing sweet science about this. This is absolute brawl.
At the end of the day, Johnny knows he stands up Buglioni, he gets out boxed. He's got to do what's good for him, and good for him is to get in close and make Buglioni work. Buglioni wears his heart in his sleeve, he will fire back. And that gives Markham the opportunity to catch Buglioni.
Buglioni says they've improved him, the Collins brothers, tactically. Well, this isn't about tactics now. Two rounds to go, heart and desire in the closing stages.
You know, this is where Buglioni wants to be, on that long jab. Use that jab, pop the jab in Markham's face, stop him coming in. As soon as Markham gets in, he makes a hard night for Buglioni.
Frank Buglioni's father on the far side of the ring, a constant companion throughout his boxing career. He looks a little bit of a worried man.
Yeah, it's a tough fight, and you know, I used to think about how much my dad must have felt watching me fight. You know, I can't even watch my little boy sparring at the moment, so I don't know what these fathers are going through. But you know, it's a tough man's fight. But Markham in this round, he's just let Buglioni dictate for the first minute, and you know, that's been the problem for some of the rounds of Markham.
Markham had a huge effort in that last round, and he's been pretty much on the receiving end for the first minute or so here.
Yeah, he haven't closed that distance. He's been picked off coming in by Buglioni.
How much has Markham still got left in the tank? The way we were seeing it, he really needs to win these last two rounds if he's going to win the fight.
Yeah, it was a huge effort in the last round, and you know, he's allowed Buglioni to dictate the fight so far this round. You know, every time he walked in without throwing a shot, and Buglioni's caught him with two or three coming in.
Still on the front foot, Markham, but just not letting the gloves go.
Yeah, he's walking Buglioni down, but he's getting caught. You know, a lot of these punches are landing on the gloves, but a lot are getting through as well. You know, Buglioni's giving the impression he's out working Markham, which he is. And he, you know, he's throwing some nice shots. He's got back in his bike, he's got his distance, which is good.
Maybe they're not actually getting to the scoring area, but when, you know, judges are only human, they're watching it, and they're going to be impressed by volume of punches thrown as much as what's landing. And Buglioni is certainly outworking Markham in this round, and big time.
Yeah, they're landing on the gloves, John, but they are landing. This, you know, like we watched against Floyd Mayweather, Pacquiao last week, and you know, the punches weren't landing by Pacquiao. He had no impression he was doing anything. But Buglioni just keep peppering those shots, keep popping Markham with those shots. You know, and he's working and he is landing.
Well, Markham was trying to set himself up for an onslaught there, and Buglioni matching fire with fire and fighting beautifully off the ropes.
Yeah, really good boxing by Buglioni there.
Good round for the champion, this. And not too much coming from Markham.
Good shot there by Markham.
Two big swings, but in the closing stages, and that after the fight, the round has been dominated by Buglioni.
Yeah, good run by Buglioni.
Markham knew it as well, touch of gloves.
Yeah, good run, very good run. Boxed well, kept the pace up, and you know, he didn't allow Markham to set himself and throw him a shot. But I think Markham's going to come out this round and just give it everything he got.
When you're on the long range, he's trying to throw big bombs at you, okay?
Yeah.
Frankie, get in there with him. Don't lose your balance, get right behind, stand there with him. And you drive them shots up inside. Some more words, Dave. You drive them shots up inside, okay? You drive them. Okay, it's a great fight.
Last round, Frank.
Hands up tight, don't move back. Yeah. Get in there on top and smudge him. And when you're ready to go again, you go, drive them up inside. Yeah. Frankie, stay close to him.
Okay. It's a war, Frank.
He has to stop you to win this.
You're winning the fight.
Okay. Last round. This has been a tough, tough fight for both men. We've got Buglioni significantly ahead, a three-round margin, but it could be closer. It may even be down to the last round. You never know.
Yeah, really good fight this, John. Well, Markham's going to have to come out here to win this fight. And surely they're going to tell him in the corner he needs a knockdown, a couple of knockdowns. Maybe, obviously, the knockout. You know, he needs to throw everything he's got.
Well, you've got to take it away from the champion. You really have to wrestle it away. And Markham, oh, good shot! Great right hand.
And a left.
Buglioni takes it, though. Markham needs to follow it up, needs a huge last round, and he's not made a bad start to it. Big uppercut and the left hook. Buglioni still looks as though he's got his senses about him, but Markham bullying him back. Left uppercut this time from Markham.
Good round so far from Markham. He knows he needs a knockout. He possibly needs a knockout. And he's given it everything he got.
Huge round needed from Lee Markham. And he's showing himself to be one very, very tough fighter indeed. Still he comes.
Yeah, cracking effort here by Markham.
Rival sets of fans chanting their appreciation. Not too much cute defence here, both of them landing with bombs.
Oh, this is what we wanted to see. I think this is what we expected to see as well, John. These boys' styles have gelled very well. Nice right hand again by Markham.
Coming up now, towards the last minute. It's still on the line.
What a fight.
Good right hand from Buglioni. Markham head down, trying to get his head onto the chest of Buglioni and somewhere find maybe one big right hand. Listen to the crowd.
Brilliant.
It's toe-to-toe as we come towards the finishing line.
Yeah, good punching there by Buglioni, trying to find himself some space.
Is there a grandstand finish from either? Two dog-tired fighters who've given everything.
Brilliant.
And that's a champion's resolve from Buglioni in the closing seconds. Both of them raise their arms. The fans have been the winners. Terrific fight.
Yeah, what a great fight. Both of them stood toe-to-toe the majority of the fight. Cracking fight.
How did you go that last round?
I give that one to Markham. You know, he come out and he forced the fight.
Well, you've got it 6-4, Buglioni, Enzo. 6-4, Buglioni, but who knows? A lot of those rounds were close, and it is an anxious wait for both men. I don't think too many people at ringside can say with any certainty who has won that fight, except the three guys who've scored it. Everybody standing and applauding. Buglioni taking the plaudits of his fans. Lee Markham supporters similarly acclaiming their fighter. And István Kovács, the WBO representative, great fighter in his own right in years gone by. He is presiding over the tallying of the scores. And the two fighters waiting anxiously. Some really torrid action in these last 3 minutes.
Yeah, fantastic fight. Markham knew he needed a knockdown. He knew he might possibly need a knockout, and he just gave it everything he got. And, you know, Buglioni fired back. You know, he wasn't going to get outdone by Markham. Brilliant fight, John. Really enjoyed. We'd like to see this one again.
Yeah, some people say, well, hey, WBO European super middleweight title. What does that mean? But what it does mean is you've got two fighters in there who had the style to make that a fight to linger in the memory. Cracking scrap.
But what it does mean, John, it means something to these boys, as they've shown
indeed
tonight. And unless you've actually boxed, unless you've been to any sort of level, you understand what it means to these boys just to have a title, whatever title. You know, it was a good fight, and they showed how much they wanted it.
They go back to the amateurs. In the amateurs, it was one apiece. Buglioni won one, lost one. Markham, 1-1, lost one. Now we come to the final deliberations of the judges. Master of ceremony is poised. Fighters are together. Who's won it? Let's find out.
Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for two boxers who gave their all. After 10 rounds of boxing, we go to the scorecard. Ferenc Buday scores the contest 94-96, Markham. Dave Paris, 96-94, Buglioni. Judge Martinez scores the contest 95-95. This contest is a draw.
I think that is a great result. Dave Paris, the judge who gave it to Buglioni, was sitting right in front of us, saw it from our angle, saw what we saw, gave it the same way that we scored it. The others found it a different way, won by Markham by a similar margin, and the third, crucially, a draw. And personally, I have no complaint at all about that, and I wouldn't mind seeing it again.
And don't bet against that. A fantastic performance from the carpenter, Lee Markham. And we're going to hear from both fighters with Charlie in just a moment. There's disappointment in the corner there from Paddy Collins and from Frank Buglioni. But Gary Lockett and Stevie Lillis with me at ringside. Okay, how do we all score it? I scored around even though I hate doing, but I had Markham by one. What about you?
I had, I had Buglioni by one, but you know, it was so many close rounds, you know, yep, and it could have gone either way, I think.
I had a draw at it, 95-95.
There you go.
Getting so many close rounds, and if it had gone either way, no one could have moaned, as long as it wasn't wide, the scorecards. They've just got, look, they've got to do it again. You know, the crowd here, the last two rounds, everyone was on their feet. There's got to be a rematch soon.
You love those rematches, don't you?
Steve
Lee, I'd love to see that again, but you called it right.
Hats off to both guys, though, right? Look, they both left it in the ring, and that's what we want to see in fights like this. You know, they both left it in the ring. The last round was phenomenal. And, you know, look, it's a fair result, a draw, I think.
And when you look at the action down there, Steve, a right old tear-up, yeah, and in the end we couldn't separate them.
You know, what we were saying before, so, you know, Lee works as a carpenter. He wants to be a full-time boxer, and did he show how much he wanted it tonight? You know what? All credit to Frank. You know, them last couple rounds, I think them last couple rounds are what clawed it back for him to get the draw. They can both leave that ring with heaps of credit and not a bad word about either of them tonight.
They
fantastic
have both
fight.
They both left the ring. They both settled down with Charlie.
Yeah, they certainly have. Neither have got smiles on their faces. But firstly, gents, I want to congratulate you on such an incredible fight. You couldn't take your eyes off it, and all of the fans were stood on their feet cheering both of you on. I'll come to you firstly, Frank, because I know you had a point to prove going into this fight, and I was going to say maybe you've proved that point, but the look on your face when you got the draw, maybe not.
Yeah, I was obviously disappointed with the draw. I thought Markham was landing some good light shots, but in the pros, the big shots that count, and a couple of times I see his legs buckle and a nice body shot, which I thought might have clinched rounds, but it's boxing, and I'll come again, I'll learn from it.
Lee, was that the fight, go to Lee, was that the fight of your life? You said before the fight that you couldn't go the distance and you needed to get the knockout to win.
Yeah. So, my last fight was pretty much similar, but I think that tops it, you know, and they were talking about my last fight being one of the fights of the year, so I'm sure that's going to top it. I thought I nicked it, to be honest, but, you know, I did know the game points, you know, it might not go my way, you know.
There was a couple of times you did try and go for the knockout. Were you disappointed?
Oh, yeah, I was trying to go for the knockout from round one, but, you know, if Frank's got a good chin or I can't punch to save my life, so one of the two, you know.
Frank, talking of good chins and defence, your team behind you have constantly worked on that, and that's been the talk of you all the time, is the fact that you haven't got a defence. Do you think you showed that in the ring tonight?
No, I didn't. I didn't box as well as I have been in the gym. So, obviously, I've got to go back and rectify and look at that and see where I went wrong. But as I say, I was catching a lot of shots on the gloves and coming back with my own counters that seemed to be doing a bit more damage. But I'll go back, I'll look at the video and then regroup.
Gents, I'd just like to come to you really quickly. Where do you think he did go wrong?
We didn't think he went wrong at all. We thought Frank nicked the fight. I mean, Markham came to win. It was a big challenge for him, a big opportunity for him. We're happy with Frank's, you know, passes worked a lot with Frank's defence. You know, everything was, we thought we won tonight. He put up a great performance. It was a great fight, a great domestic fight for TV and for everybody to see, but we just thought we nicked it, you know.
It was an incredible fight, and the grudge hasn't been settled, so you know what I'm going to ask you? Rematch?
Of course, I'm well up for a rematch. Credit to Lee, he came and he brought his aim game, like he said he would. So, yeah, hopefully we can get the rematch on.
Lee, what's your answer to that?
Yeah, of course, yeah, why not?
Frank, rematch? I asked you that before they came and sat down, and you just kind of looked at me blankly.
No, I think it's a natural rematch, there's no doubt about that. And for the neutrals, what a fabulous fight it was. It was, you know, touch and go all the way. But, I think a rematch is in order, and I'm sure, you know, the guys would like it. So we'll work on that one. But, you know, I was so pleased that what a great fight it was. You know, there's a lot of history between the two of them. Not bad history, but there's a lot of history going back to the amateurs. And you could see that in the fight. They rose above, you know, their levels at times and pulled it all out, and I think that, you know, the fans had a fabulous fight tonight.
I bet you'd like the rest of your boxers to have a fight like that and fight like that, wouldn't you?
For the fans, it's great. For a manager, you're sitting there and you're on the edge of your seat. But, you know, the bottom line of it is, you know, they've done fabulously well. They entertained everybody. And as you say, it's a great natural rematch, and we'll work on that.
Thanks, Frank. I'm just going to go back to Frank for a second, because I'd like to talk to you about maybe the Commonwealth title. Is that something that you do have in your head, maybe with Butledge?
Yeah, of course, but obviously we've got unfinished business, so hopefully we can get this back on. But if the Commonwealth title's there, then it's a good stepping stone, and I'm well up for that, whatever Frank's got in plan for me.
And before I let you both go, as I said, the fans were literally on their feet. So what do you want to say to both of your fans? Because it was one of the most incredible fans' performances I've seen for a long time.
Yeah, great fight. Credit to Lee. Credit to all his support for making such a great atmosphere. And hopefully we'll get it on again.
Lee?
Yeah, I'd like to say thanks. I know Frank does a lot of tickets, but, you know, my fans was matching him. They were both as good as each other, so I can only thank them for coming and spending all their money.
So back in the gym, and we hope to see that exactly again.
Cheers.
Thank you.
And great to see the handshake, and great to see the respect between